Hello my crafty friends and welcome back to another card making video. Today I'm having fun with foiling. It's that time of the month where I'm sharing a project using the Spellbinders foiling kit. This is what you get for August. You will get those hexagons that you can foil as well as die cut, and there is also a sentiment that fits right inside there. You will see how I'm going to work with that. And then you get two flower compositions. These will create stunning backgrounds to help your sentiment pop on top of your card. You will also get this foil roll, however, I'm going to work with the gold one which I have from a previous kit. So here on a white card base I aligned the two flower compositions. You can see that I made sure that everything stays in place by using my tape there. And I did align the sentiment inside one of the hexagons, and I'm going to foil it on a separate piece of cardstock as well. I did press the button and I'm waiting for that flashing light to stop flashing. Once that's done, it means that the plate is warm enough and I can run it through my die cutting machine. If you are wondering, I'm working on Nina Solar White cardstock, which is 80 pounds. I like to run it a couple of times through my die cutting machine, and I'm taking my time, which allows the foil to get transferred on my white cardstock. I'm going to peel it off so you can see what I got. Here is my sentiment included in that hexagon, lovely and shiny, and I'm going to remove that as well, which is going to be my background. Now, if you do that on a dark background with a lovely color of foil, it's going to be the perfect background and you don't really need to do anything on top of it. All that shine is going to make your card really pop. However, in my case, I'm going to use my alcohol markers to color in the flowers. First, I'm going to die cut the sentiment. So again, I'm using one of the dies included in the kit. And instead of die cutting the sentiment so that you can later pop it on top of your card, remember that you can use the hexagons to create a shaker card or even a window card. Just a couple of extra ideas on how you can use this kit. So here I'm going to use my alcohol markers. Don't worry about going over the lines of foiling. The alcohol marker doesn't affect the foiling at all. You will find out at the end that it's going to be nice and shiny. And of course you can go with other coloring mediums if you wish so. You can always foil on top of watercolor paper and then you can go with your watercolors or just go with your colored pencils. And with the magic of video editing, here it is all colored. You can see that the alcohol marker didn't affect the foiling at all. The outline is nice and shiny. I'm going to stick the sentiment at the center of my panel. Then I'm going to create a 4.25 by 5.5 card base. I looked through my stash for a card base that matched the colors of the flowers. And when I'm using a dark card base, I always like to stick on the inside a piece of white panel so that I can easily write my message. To finish off my card, I did add a few pearls, and here are some close-up photos. It's a very versatile design. Switch up the sentiment to match your occasion. And also make similar cards, but instead of popping the sentiment on top, just die cut a window for a window card or a shaker card. So that was the video for today. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. Don't forget to leave me a comment, to like and subscribe if you haven't done so already. You will find a list of all the supplies that I use, just like always, down below in the description area. Thank you for joining me today, and I hope you'll all have a lovely day.